Welcome to our presentation, an OER for a practice-based profession, videos for teaching communication skills and social work. My name is Marie Nightbird and my co-presenter is Kelly Allison. We are both assistant professors of teaching at the School of Social Work at UBC in Vancouver. We would like to acknowledge that UBC Vancouver is on the traditional, ancestral and unceded territories of the Musqueam people. The learning objectives for this session are as follows. By the end of this lightning talk, you will be able to describe the benefit of using open educational resources in teaching and learning for practice-based professions. Describe how demonstration videos can enhance learning of communication skills in both online and face-to-face environments. Describe the process and considerations for creating accessible multimedia OERs. And finally, locate an OER for teaching communication skills in social work. As many of you are already aware, OERs are defined as teaching, learning, and research resources that reside in the public domain or have been released under an intellectual property license that permits their free use and repurposing by others. Most common OERs are textbooks. However, in some disciplines, such as practice-based professions, other types of teaching and learning resources are valuable. We hope this presentation will help you think about other OERs beyond the textbook. Learning in practice-based professions is unique because a significant portion of learning is experiential and accomplished through field education, which is sometimes referred to as practicums, placements, or internships. Some examples of practice-based professions are social work, nursing, medicine, and education. These disciplines require pedagogical tools suited for this applied learning. Using OERs, students, classroom teachers, and field instructors can access teaching and learning materials as needed in their respective settings. Some content crosses disciplines in many practice-based professions, including topics such as communication skills. Therefore, shared learning resources can benefit a wide array of students and can be adapted by individual disciplines. With the ever-changing nature of the knowledge and skill base of practice-based professions, OERs can allow for easy and efficient revising and updating of discipline content. Kelly and I teach a communication skills course, which includes basic interviewing and counseling skills. The class meets weekly for 3 hours. The first half of the class includes lectures and small group discussions regarding key concepts and skills. The second half of the class allows students to practice the communication skills taught that day using role plays in a simulated counseling session. As instructors, we know that demonstration is a powerful teaching method rooted in social learning theory and the apprenticeship model of education. Therefore, we really wanted to be able to provide students with other opportunities to see the skills beyond the live demonstrations we provide in our classes. Consequently, we decided to create some teaching videos.
Our OER for teaching communication skills is a toolkit that consists of a package of 5 demonstration videos, a teaching guide, and both instructor and student transcripts for the videos. In creating the videos, we wrote scripts for the counselor and client interaction, hired actors, and liaised with UBC studios to film and produce the videos. In deciding to produce these videos, we were aware that technology can enhance student learning and that videos are an effective educational tool. They allow students to access content both inside and outside of the classroom, which gives them flexibility and control over their learning and can provide supplementary learning materials. We have used our resource in both face-to-face and online teaching. Students in our online course really benefited from our videos as there were limited opportunities to provide demonstration of these skills. students in both face-to-face and online courses appreciated the additional examples of other social workers demonstrating the skills, and that they could review them again outside of class on their own time. Our multimedia OER reflects some of the considerations the research highlights for effective multimedia design, such as cognitive load. Students can only take in manageable pieces of information at a time. All of our videos are between 5 and 10 minutes in length. The cognitive theory of multimedia learning tells us that memory is enhanced when both auditory and visual channels are used. Our videos use two processes that reduce cognitive load. Signaling is on-screen text or images which highlight important information. We use text to simultaneously identify the communication skills being demonstrated. Segmenting involves chunking information into manageable pieces. We therefore divided the 13 communication skills into 4 videos demonstrating 2 to 3 skills each, with a final video demonstrating an amalgamation of all skills. Another consideration is student engagement. We aspire to create real-world appeal by using a mock professional counseling setting to garner interest. Lastly, we considered active learning. We created a teaching guide to offer strategies to help students solidify their learning of these skills. Our teaching guide includes transcripts, discussion prompts, and a range of interactive learning activities to be used alongside the videos. Since publishing our OER in July 2020, we have continued to learn about open education and realized we wanted to make revisions to our resource to make it more open. We made the following changes. We had initially licensed our work under BYND, which meant we did not allow derivatives. We have since relicensed our OER as CC-BY-NC to create more openness, allowing others to revise and adapt our work. We tagged our videos housed on a YouTube channel with a Creative Commons license. This enabled YouTube to provide video editing tools to allow others to revise or remix our videos with ease. The inclusion of transcripts allowed for some accessibility. We wanted to increase accessibility, so we enabled closed captioning in our YouTube videos. From our experience, we offer the following consideration in making multimedia OERs. First, before embarking on any OER creation, see if there's open content you could reuse or revise. In our case, we could not find any videos to fit our context, so we decided to make our own. When providing content through multimedia, consider issues of cognitive load and ways to reduce it, such as signaling and segmenting. Think about how to make your multimedia engaging for students and include active learning strategies. Determine the degree of openness you want for your OER and choose the corresponding license that allows users to engage in the 5R activities. Think about accessibility. Accessible materials are designed to make them usable across the widest range of learner variability. Choose an application that will make it easy for others to revise or adapt your content. In our case, YouTube provided easy access to tools for revisions. Lastly, ensure your resource is discoverable. Choose a well-known OER repository for your discipline and the descriptors that will make it easy to locate. We chose Merlot because it was a platform that had the most social work content.
You can access our toolkit for teaching communication skills and social work on Merlot under Social Work Resources.
Thanks for listening. And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out. Our emails are included here.